Yeah, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, viewers at home. My name is Opeyemi Shosanya, and I want to welcome you, especially to this another session of Church Gist. It's a privilege for me to have in the studio a wonderful friend, a brother, and a father, somebody that we have been together, you know, right from childhood. Join me to welcome Mr. Obi Ikechukwu Kenneth. Good afternoon, Mr. Obi.
Good afternoon, and good afternoon, our viewers.
Yeah.
Good to be here.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to have you in the studio this afternoon. We'll be discussing on the church and the companies and the allied matters heart. You know, I've been able to read some of your comments on social media. I've been able to convince a lot of people, you know, on this controversy that is going on, you know, over the social media, especially how it affects the church. So this afternoon we'll be talking on the church and the companies allied matters heart. Before we go, let me introduce to you my guest, Mr. Obi Ikechukwu Kenneth. Mr. Kenneth Obi Ikechukwu is a business development manager at Carmen Aggregate Construction Company. I hope I get that right. Okay. Yeah, he's an ex-banker at Fidelity Bank PLC. I just wonder why somebody will leave the banking sector. And he's also a political analyst and a current affairs communicator. Mr. Ikechukwu is married to a beloved wife, Neka Sandra Obunike.
Obunike.
Yeah. Madam is saying hi to you at home. And is blessed with children. You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
Okay. Yeah, thank you. Right, straight to the business. Yeah. What is your stand on the recent presidential presidential ascent to Kano?
I would like to say it is a welcome development because we have been on it for some time now. The bill has been sitting at the National Assembly for some time, but we thank God that it has been accepted to after passing of the bill. So it's a very welcome development.
You are saying you are thanking God.
It's a good thing. It's a very good thing. We have the controversial area of it, but we cannot throw away the baby with the bathwater. You understand? So we can always look at the ambiguities in it and try to sort those things out. Yeah. Okay. But it's a welcome development. It's good for business.
Wow.
Yes. It's good for business.
Now we are talking about business.
Yes.
And what we are looking at today is how it affects church.
Yes.
Is there anything missing?
Nothing is missing. Because the business of church, in quote, and other business, the traditional kind of business that we know, they are all encompassing under this camera. So, but the area that has been too controversial is the one that has to do with church. But there's something I would like you to know. It wasn't pinpointed in camera that this particular section is for the church. But as we go on, I will delve into those areas.
Okay. Yeah. Thank you. That's a brilliant one. But you've seen this document?
Yes, I've seen it.
All right. But let me ask you, do you think this is what we need in our country, considering issues that surround the economy, you know, and all that? Do you think Kano should be what we should be addressing?
No, this is a country that has many parts. And one part is not, let's say, something that is mutual exclusive. We can be running this and still be running others simultaneously.
Okay.
So Kama coming at this point, like I said earlier, is a welcome development.
Okay.
There are areas that are controversial.
Okay.
But there's nothing wrong in the timing of Kama. Yeah, it's good.
You're so sure of this.
Very, very good for business. Yes.
Thank you so much, Mr. Ike. So now let me ask you, as a political analyst, don't you think this bill, which is now a law,
because
it has,
exactly.
Don't you think it has a political or religious undertone?
The thing is, we are in Nigeria, a secular state, but you know we are very, very religious in Nigeria, so we cannot divorce religious undertone or political undertone from the kind of laws we make for ourselves.
Okay.
They are there. That is why we have the noise. Because some aspects, some areas of some religions are looking at it differently. So definitely, we cannot dissociate religion, politics from our way of life. So therefore, inside our laws too, those things are embedded in it. So that's just the way it is. There is political and then religious undertone.
Okay. So for us to acknowledge the fact that there is a political and religious, don't you think that is not too good for us as a country?
No, the laws are for the people, not the people for the law. So it's the people that gave themselves the law. So definitely anything you believe in, while you are making the law, we have some imputes into the law we are making for ourselves. We can't just shy away from that. Let's not just be like us rich. No, no, definitely. Everything we make for ourselves, we consider our religion, we consider the politics. So it's not bad.
Okay. Thank you so much. Now, viewers at home, I think it's getting more interesting in the studio. So we'll go for some commercials, then we'll come back. Yeah, you're welcome back from the commercials. With me still in the studio is Mr. Ike Obi. Yeah, thank you very much. So, Mr. Ike, from the noise, you know, that has been going around, you know, a lot of issues here and there, some people who find that this karma is meant to reach on the Christians. What's your take on this?
I don't want to tone that up. If you have checkmated yourself, there wouldn't have been a need for another person to checkmate. So that's just the baseline. Now, there are some particular block of the can that are not seeing anything wrong with what is going on. And again, I think the way it is being presented by church leaders are the basis for all these agitations. The presentation was not well done.
So, you know, presentations from
The church leaders.
Okay.
To the Christians.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah.
It was not properly done. The way it is being presented is as if it singled out Christians. No. Any organization that is registered under the Corporate Affairs Commission as an NGO, there's a particular section of the Karma Act that talks about that organization. Yes. So the major aspect that is giving us all this Ulabalu is a particular, is a section 836 or something. I can't really pick that now. There are talks about the trustees of an NGO that give the government the power to dissolve the trustee of a certain organization and appoint others to take over the organization if they feel there are some misconduct that are being perpetrated in the organization. So as a Christian, talking for myself this time around, if we are held in very high level of probity, I don't think this should be any problem to us. Yes. We should be able to be the one teaching others how to do this in terms of being accountable, purposeful leadership.
So now that the government is coming to, I want to use your word, checkmate now.
Yes.
The activities of the Christians.
Not the Christians, organization.
Of the organization.
Yes.
Okay. So, is anything too big in that?
There's not too big, but I can tell you for free that there are still some ambiguities in the act.
So, where are we missing it? Where are we getting it all wrong? I mean, I'm talking, you know, this is a church gist program, so I'm speaking on behalf of the Christians. You know, so where did we disconnect from, you know, the truth of this bill, of this act?
I think it goes back to the presentation.
Okay.
Nigerians don't read. So we believe in this word of mouth. And now you have held your pastor in that high level. Highest level of esteem, regards, and anything it throws at you, you take hook, line, and sinker. You don't even want to engage your brain. Okay, let me go to this book. Let me see what is inside of this.
Yeah.
So now it depends on how your pastor presents this to the congregation. If he presents it in a very good way, you can see everybody tagging along.
Mm.
But if he presents it the other way around,
yeah,
that would be agitation.
Okay. Maybe you should, let me stop you there. But don't you think for Kama to stipulate that there will be change in trustees if they are found wanting,
yeah,
you know, and all that, don't you think this should be a subject of, you know, concern? Because
yeah,
why would, you know, Christian be found wanting of corrupt practices and all that? Yeah.
So that area, when I said there were some ambiguities,
yeah,
in it,
yeah,
is one of the areas. Mm. It's not as if I'm against getting trustees to take over from those,
yeah,
who are found wanting.
Mm.
But it should be stipulated the kind of people,
okay,
that are to be made trustees,
mm,
when one has been dissolved.
Okay.
Now that area is blank.
Mm.
You don't know the age limit, you don't know the professional background,
yeah,
we don't know the religious background,
yeah,
of those that people
person, yeah,
that will take over.
Yeah.
That is the only area I have some
doubts.
Yeah. And it's not by making noise all over the place,
yeah,
it's not by raining curses from the altar.
Yeah.
There are some steps you need to take,
okay,
to get this thing amended.
Mm.
Yes. We can still go back to those people that promulgated or,
yeah,
the law.
Yeah, I agree with you. Recently, even the vice president said, if you know you are not cool with this, you know, then go back to
go back area. To
but do you think, yeah, because if you look at, you know, I asked the question the other time, that don't you think Kama has political undertone, you know, and
everything
all that?
It's like jollof.
So yeah. Yeah, so probably the Christian leaders will be looking at it that, well, even regardless of how they take this thing too far, they will still look for a way around it to still present it the way it used to be.
No, we shouldn't always see ourselves as the victim.
Okay.
What I see the church is doing now is reactionary.
Mm.
We preach being proactive.
Don't you think they should react?
They should react, mm, but not in this way.
There
are channels.
How do you think church should,
yes,
react?
Yes, go back to the National Assembly.
Mm.
Let it be known that this particular area is more or less offensive,
okay,
to the Christian faith.
Faith, yeah.
Then you lobby some people. We have Christians, we have pastors,
mm,
in the National Assembly.
Okay. Yeah.
People from different denominations.
Mm.
So it's not as if a wool was placed on people's eye and the law was
cool,
taken to maybe Saudi Arabia and do something, mm, and present it to the president. It must have passed through some readings,
yeah,
public hearings.
Yes.
So why are we not,
yeah,
coming
see,
out in that
things,
area,
yeah,
why was it that we had to wait until the president,
mm,
gave an assent,
assent,
before, you know, it started coming out from different areas? No, that was reactionary. It's,
yeah,
not proactive at all.
Okay, thank you very much for,
mm,
sharing your thoughts with us. Yeah, now let me ask you, in your view, don't you think the Registrar General of a Corporate Affairs Commission, you know, has suddenly become more powerful, you know, with the considering the content of Kama?
Yeah, to an extent.
Mm.
Mm, the powers within his purview,
yeah,
has gone up. But there are some things we should know too about this particular section.
Yeah.
Most of the steps that were to be taken,
mm,
you have to get a court order,
okay,
to take it. It's not something that you just take.
Was that written in
it
Kama?
It was, yeah.
Because I think this is one of the areas that people are talking about, that saying without even, if they will remove, there's going to be a removal of a trustee without even recourse
by
to
an order.
By another.
Yes.
Okay.
So the power has gone up.
Yeah.
But it wasn't absolute.
Okay.
You still have to get order from the court before you can carry out anything you can carry out.
Okay.
And now when things like this are happening, there is a particular part of the section,
mm,
that say 1/5 of the members of the organization can complain, bringing out evidences.
Yeah.
So it's not as if,
yeah,
the registrar just woke up at the wrong side of the bed and said, okay, this particular church. I want to deal with you today. You know, that kind of thing. But that was the way these things are being presented in churches.
Yeah.
Somebody can just wake up. And again, karma doesn't stop the preacher from preaching. The Great Commission says we should go into the world and make disciples. Yes. It doesn't stop you. What karma is talking about is the trustees. Your business still continues. Your business of evangelization continues.
Yeah.
If they say, okay, you are the head pastor, you are part of the trustees. If you are relieved of that position in the trustees, you are still the person preaching. Nobody's taking over your job. You are still doing your job. And now, if there must be a suspension because of the acts of misconduct and stuff like that, it must not exceed 12 months. That was stipulated and is still there in the karma. So I don't see why we should be crying about this. Seriously. Seriously. We just need to get ourselves educated. Yeah.
Yeah, and that's why you are here for us. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts with us. Let me ask you this question. What do you think Christians should have done before? Although you've said something about that, but I want you to elaborate, you know, I want you to explain it the more. What do you think Christians should have done before or at the promulgation of this act?
Yeah, this act has been on for some time now. In the last over 2 decades, this act has been the way it was until of recent, where there were amendments.
Okay.
From the beginning, from the process of even raising a bill towards the amendment of this Karma Act, the Christians in the National Assembly, the Christian associations can always, should have all lobbied the National Assembly. Okay, this thing you are trying to impute. Because there will be some readings now, first reading, second reading. It will affect our interest. So talk to your people of the same faith. Let others see the reason why this thing should not be the way it is. And now,
why do you think Christians are not doing that?
I just felt we prefer playing the victim. Yes, we prefer playing the victim. You know, some people have talked about Islamization. Now, to now make that word Islamization
reality.
Be reality, it will now make you feel, okay, we told you this thing and it's happening. But while these things were going on, you folded your hands. You allow all those things to pass. The public hearing, the presentation of the bill, everything, even to the presidential assent. It will interest you to know. You know already that our vice president is a pastor from a very large denomination in the country. What happens to our ability to lobby people? Okay, vice president, these are the misgivings we have about this act. Can you talk to the president to withhold the assent? Take this thing back to the National Assembly. Let those areas be sorted out. Those ambiguous areas. Because some people will tell you that they can just wake up and an allergy is made to oversee
exactly.
The trustees.
Those are the things going around.
Those ones are very silent. We don't have any word on that. So why not take this thing back? Let those areas be sorted before it comes back. Then you can give your assent. But we seem not to be bothered about being proactive. We just want, okay, we've said it, Islamization is coming, this president is this, is that, okay, you can see for yourself, no. It shouldn't be that way.
Okay, let me ask you, don't you think the president actually have that agenda to Islamize the country?
He doesn't.
Mm.
He doesn't. He has been here like 4 or 5 times before he finally got to be the president. On 2 occasions, he chose pastors to be his running mates.
Yeah, remember to Bakari.
You know, we have pastors and we have firebrands. He didn't just go around and pick one that is doing Muslim, Christian, all those. But he went for the firebrands. If you add that kind of agenda we have got to pick somebody that is very, very liberal about religion. No, I don't think he has that agenda. No.
Wow, it's nice talking to you, Mr. Haike. Thank you so much. Then we go for another commercials. When we come back, we continue, you know, for the last part of the question. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
All right. Okay, viewers at home, I welcome you back from commercials, and still with me is Mr. I.K. Obi, you know, who has been educating us on the church and the Kama. Ha, thank you very much. The next question is this. Do you think the interest of Christians is protected in this law? You know, considering diverse belief system in the country.
Yeah, the law was not promulgated to protect a particular section of the country, whether religious, business, or political. This is a law that is meant for everybody in the country. So I don't think we should be talking about interest of a as in a particular denomination or religious entity.
Okay.
Everybody is seen as one in this law.
Regardless of your faith.
Atheists are welcome. Muslims are welcome. Any religion you can just have.
Okay.
So there's no point talking about protecting a particular interest. No. It's for everybody. It's for Nigerians.
For some time now, you know, over the social media, you know, and all that, you see some pastors talking about, okay, we are comparing Nigeria with the UK, that things are not done even the way we are doing, you know, with the way we are doing things, that over there, churches were giving grants, you know, to carry out a particular humanitarian service and all that, but here, it can never happen. If you compare these two, then why are we tilting towards
my own take on this is that I don't think we have any basis of comparison. Nigeria is a sovereign state. We make the laws for ourselves.
Okay.
And these laws were made by Nigerians. We should not even start comparing ourselves to the United Kingdom. Even from the system of government we run, they are different. So this is Nigeria. Let Nigerians face their law. If there's any area you want this law to be amended, or you want a particular part of the law to be expunged, let's still do it as Nigerians. There's so many things going on over there in the UK that are not going on here. So I don't think we should start comparing now. Let's make laws that suit ourselves and our environment. Let's forget the UK for now. They have their own battles to face. So let's be Nigerian.
All right. Thank you very much. So let me ask you, what is the way forward? Considering what is happening, government, Christians, Kama, Muslims, what is the way forward in this country?
The way forward, especially for the Christians, is being proactive. And we should just remove this mentality of victimization. The country is for everybody. We've been selling this issue of victimization to our followers a long time ago. We should leave that aspect. We are Christians. Let's preach love. And now we cannot go to bed while things are going on. And when it's concluded, start shouting, no. Let there be proactivity in Christendom. And don't always see the other person as your enemy. And one other thing is this, even in Christendom, there are so many fragmentations. The divisions are very loud, very, very loud. Somebody from this denomination may not want to have anything to do with this other denomination.
Yeah.
Now, we've taken the eyes of Jesus. He's not my G.O., my papa, and the spiritual leader. Some will even go as far as telling you that we are your spiritual covering, your prosperity is tied to my anointing, you know, that kind of thing. So the focus is no longer on Jesus. Yes. Some will tell you that they are the Jesus that you can see. Can you imagine that? So many people can carry knives, guns to defend their passports. But how many can do that for Christ? So the focus have shifted. We can now refocus to Christ.
How did we get here?
It was a gradual and subtle way. You know, the more you listen to some things, the more it forms the way you live your life. Those are the preachings and this and that. They talk about Jesus less. They would rather talk about demons. They would rather talk about demons more. Some will tell you, if you do this, if you don't do this, when the demons start coming after you, don't call me. You know, that kind of thing. As if Christians cannot attend to demons by themselves. So rather talk about Jesus, talk about love that he represents. Because what really brought Jesus to us is the love. For God so loved the world. And when you love, there must be an action to back it up. And his giving. So what really brought Jesus to us and what Jesus exemplified has been thrown to the background. Now it's one papa that is wearing big agbada, that is using private jets. I'm not against that, but the focus has shifted. Now, instead of Jesus is the papa, and the papa now makes you see the other person as trying to impose his own religion on you. There are some churches that you don't see intermarriages in those churches.
If
we are not a member of it, this is this, that is that, you know, that kind of thing. That fragmentation is much. So we rather look for somebody to blame for something than we taking the blame. None of our leaders now is taking the blame for this reactionary stuff. It's something that you should have. We have deacons, we have pastors that are legislators. We have just ordinary Christians, but none of them brought this to the fore until an assent was given by that person that they love to hate. Now, bringing the Islamization stuff into it in a very subtle manner. So I think the best thing we can do now is to refocus Christ.
Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Ike. Thank you very much. I must tell you, that is actually what you just said now is the brain, you know, behind the discussion. It's like focus has been shifted. And we just need to refocus. Need to refocus. Looking at Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. Thank you very much. So your final word, we are coming gradually to the end of the show, you know. So to the government, what do you want to say to them? Because we must say the truth, you know. They too have one way or the other. They are getting things wrong, you know, and all that. So what's your final word to the government?
Now, when we say the government, we try to distance ourselves from the government. Who is the government? We are the government. There's nobody that gets to that position from any other place than the environment. The environment cannot get what it doesn't produce. First and foremost, let's see ourselves as the government. And now back to those people that we are looking at as the government.
Are the hem of that.
So many people have so many misgivings, so many doubts about the sincerity of the government. But I think it's high time they started making people know, educating people more, speaking more to the people. One bad side of this present administration is information dissemination. We have the Ministry of Information, we have advisors on public, whatever, we have orientation agencies. But all these people, is as if there's a kind of unified way of being silent. Things are going on, but nobody knows about them. Even the good side of the government are not being publicized well. So I think this government has to do more of publicity, awareness. Education, awareness.
Thank you very much. And finally, to Nigerians, do you want them to calm down?
No, we have to calm down. We have to calm down, seriously.
Okay.
One thing that's missing in Nigeria is love. Love. And there's this suspicion.
Yeah.
This one is suspecting this.
Yeah.
That thing has been going on for some time.
Yeah.
We don't really take time to look into that.
Mm.
Until the thing got to a point that is very, very injurious and cancerous to our being. If we can love ourselves beyond tribal sentiment, religious sentiment, political sentiment, all these things we're talking about will not be dead. So Nigerians, my advice to Nigerians, let love lead.
Awesome. Thank you very much. Thank you, Mr. Ike. We've come to the end of the show. You know, I hope when we call you next time,
thank you very much.
And for the viewers at home, we want to appreciate you for your time. And in case you have any question, you see our numbers, you know, scrolling, and the email address. You can send in your questions and your comments, you know, on what Mr. Ike has said so far, you know, in the studio today. Till we see you some other time. It's Churches. God bless you. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.